Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Peace and blessings be upon you all. A very good morning, dear children. I'm Asima Ansari, your maths teacher. In the previous class, you have come to know about fractions. Let's learn some more concepts of fraction in the part 1 of Unit 7 Fractions. This part 1 of Unit 7 Fractions contains 4 concepts. First, to recall. Now, what all we are going to recall? What is a fraction? Fraction as a region or a collection, numerator and denominator of a fraction. Finding 1 halves, 1 thirds, and 1 fourths, which you have already learned in class 3. Let us recall. Now, the next one is to understand fractions better. The next is like and unlike fractions we'll be learning. And then next, equivalent fractions. After teaching these concepts, students will be able to understand fractions better. Students will be able to differentiate like and unlike fractions. Students will be able to identify and represent equivalent fractions. Let's recall fractions. A fraction shows part of a whole. A whole can be a region or a collection. Let's see what is a region. It is a region when the whole is one object. Let's understand it better with the help of an example. I have one pizza. From that, I'm taking out 2 pieces. So what will be the fraction? 2/8. Now let's check out what is a collection. It is a collection when the whole is a group of objects. Let's see with an example. Here I have a collection of roses. If I ask you what is the fraction of red roses in this collection, so what will be your answer? There are 5 flowers, out of that 3 are red. So, 3/5 of the roses are red, right? Now, if I ask you what is the fraction for yellow roses in the collection, so it will be 2/5 of the roses are yellow. Right, my children? Easy? Let's recall. Numerator and denominator of a fraction. Fraction's name, part of a region or part of a collection. So, parts being referred to and parts in all gives us the fraction. We write parts being referred to on top and parts in all at the bottom to write the fraction. So parts being referred to is called what? It's numerator, right children? And parts in all is called denominator. So here we can see that in this rectangle we have divided this rectangle into 6 parts, out of it 3 parts are shaded. So what should be in the numerator? Shaded parts. And what should be the denominator? Equal parts in all. So we have 3 as the numerator and 6 as the denominator. Now let's see a collection and check it out. We have here 5 triangles in the collection, out of which 2 are shaded. So what will be it? Shaded triangles by triangles in all. So what will be the fraction? 2/5. So what's the numerator and denominator here? 2 is the numerator and 5 is the denominator. So easy, right children? Let's recall. How to find 1/2, 1/3 and 1/4 of a fraction. We already know that to find 1/2, we divide by 2. To find 1/3, we divide by 3. To find 1/4, we divide by 4. Let's check it with an example. What is 1/3 of 1/1? The answer should be given in minutes. Now we know that 1 hour equals to 60 minutes. So this is 1/3. So to find 1/3, we divide by 3. So 60 to be divided by 3 will give us 20 minutes. Now what is 1/4 of a dozen? So we know that 1 dozen equals to 12. To find 1/4, we divide by 4. So 12 is to be divided by 4, which gives us 3. Let's see another example. What is half of 1 day? The answer should be in hours. So 1 day equals to 24 hours. So this, when it is half, when it is 1/2, we divide by 2. So 24 is to be divided by 2. So the answer we get is 12 hours. Understanding fractions better. This is Ali's chart. This is Aman's chart. Ali says he painted half of his chart. Aman says he painted half of his chart. Do you think they have painted the same amount? No, because Ali's chart is smaller than Aman's chart. So these two fractions are not equal. For fractions to be equal, they should be from the same whole or equal sized wholes. Let's practice exercise 7A. Question number 1. Which of these 1/4 shows the same amount? Let's check out the options. Now this 1/4 fraction is a circle and 1/4 is shaded, but this and this are not of the same size because this is smaller and this is bigger, so they are not having the same amount. What about this? We cannot make out because the shape is different. So no, this is not. What about the last one? It's way too small and the shape is different. I think A and D are showing the same amount. Are we correct? Yes. So let's go for the next question. Which of these shows 2/3 shaded? Let's check out the options. Now here we have a picture where they are not equally divided. One piece is way too bigger and the other two are of the same size. So we cannot even make a fraction out of this. And what about this? Again the same condition. These three pieces are of not same size. So we cannot even have a fraction. What about this? Yes, they are of the same size, but it is not 2/3 but 2/5. So this is not also not 2/3. What about this? Yes, this is 2/3. Now here two pieces are shaded out of 3 and all the pieces are of equal size. So this is 2/3. Let's practice some more questions in exercise 7A. Question number 3. If this triangle is half the shape, draw the whole shape. I think we need to draw one more triangle to get the full shape. Let's check it out. Yes, one triangle here. This is what is given. To make it full shape, we need one more. So we got the full shape. Let's go for the next question. If this square is 1/4 the shape, draw the whole shape. If it is 1/4, that means this type of squares, 3 more we need, isn't it? Let's check it out the answer. Oh yeah, we got it. This is the whole shape. Quite easy, isn't it, children? If the circle is 1/6 of a collection of shapes, draw the whole collection. Oh, one circle only has been given out of 6. That means we need to draw 5 more to make the collection, isn't it? Yes, we got the whole collection. 6 circles in all. Was it easy, my children? Did you like it? Like and unlike fractions. Let's know what are like and unlike fractions. Now, like fractions. Fractions that have same denominator are called like fractions. Let's understand it better with the help of an example. We have here 2/3 and 1/3. This fraction is 2/3 and here it is 1/3 are like fractions because both have the same denominator, that is 3. Yes, now here this is 3 as the denominator and this also has 3 as the denominator. They have the same denominator, that's why they are like. Now can you guess what can be unlike fractions? The opposite of it, isn't it? Maybe the opposite of it. Let's check out. So fractions that have different denominator are called unlike fractions. Yes, that's what I was saying, maybe the opposite of it. Now here, this one has 5 as the denominator and this one has 7 as the denominator, 3/5 and 2/7. So these are unlike because they don't have the same denominators. They are unlike fractions because their denominators are different. Easy, my children? So easy, isn't it? Let's learn a new concept, equivalent fractions. Let me narrate you a small story. Ali's mama bought 2 pizzas. One pizza, she break it into 4 pieces and she gave 1 piece to Ali. And another pizza, she break it into 8 pieces and she took out 2 pieces and she ate. All of a sudden, Ali started crying, saying, "Mama, you gave me only 1 piece and you ate 2 piece. You ate more." Then is it correct? Did Ali's mama eat more? No, isn't it? Even though these pizzas are, the fractions are different. Here it is 1/4 and here it is 2/8. But actually the size of the pieces are same. This one piece is equal to the 2 pieces of this pizza. Right, my children? So they are actually equal. So what can we say? 1/4 and 2/8 means the same amount. So we say 1/4 and 2/8 are equivalent fractions. So what's the definition of equivalent fractions? Fractions that name the same part are called equivalent fractions. What is it, my children? Fractions that name the same part are called equivalent fractions. It's fun, isn't it? Let's do one fun-filled activity of equivalent fraction and have fun. We need an A4 size paper for it. Take an A4 size paper and fold it into half. Vertical folding we did and we got this one. Now shade it one side with any color till the crease. So what fraction we are getting? 1/2, right? So now with the same paper, fold it once more. Now this time you fold it horizontally, open up. So it will be in quarters. Now we have this. So what fraction we got now? 2/4. So actually they are equal, isn't it? Yes, let me ask you one question. Could you think of a way to show paper folding of equivalent fraction 4/8? So how can we get with the same paper? I think when we go for a vertical folding, we will be getting a 4/8. Yes, let's see it. Okay, we got it. When we folded it vertically, we got 2 more creases and we got a 4/8. So actually these fractions are equivalent, right? So 1/2 is equal to 2/4 is equal to 4/8. So fractions that name the same part are called equivalent fraction. Clear, my children? This is a fun-filled activity. Did you enjoy? Let's see some more examples of equivalent fractions. Now, here in the previous activity we have done, we can go ahead and have many more equivalent fractions with the help of same piece of paper. As many foldings you do, as many equivalent fractions you get. So as you can see, 1/2, 2/4, 3/6, 4/8, 5/10, and so on. You keep on folding, you will keep on getting the equivalent fractions. So let's see one more example here. We have here the first stripe of paper is divided into 3 parts, out of it we have shaded 1 part. In the next one we have the same stripe which is broken into six parts, and out of it two parts are shaded. Again, the same stripe has been broken into 12 parts and four parts are shaded. We can see that all these three are equivalent. Now, 1/2 is equals to 2/6 and equals to, which is equal to 4/12. Do you think it ends here? No. As many folds you keep on making on the stripe, you will keep on getting that many equivalent fractions. So it's fun activity, my children. You should try it at home using the stripe of paper. Make different sorts of equivalent fractions and enjoy. Let's practice exercise 7B. Question number 1, identify this as like and unlike fractions. 1A, 4/5 and 3/5. Are they like fractions? Are they unlike fractions? Yes, we know the definition of like fractions. If the fractions have the same denominator, they are like. That means this is a like fraction, correct? Let's see the next question. 1/9, 1/6 and 1/2. Are they same? Oh. You may get confused seeing that 1, 1, 1 in the numerator, but we are not concerned about the numerator. We are concerned here only about the denominator. If the denominators are same, then they are like. Since here the denominators are different, this is unlike, correct? Yes, let's go for the next question. Study the shaded regions and fill in the boxes. Now we have this question. It says this is equal to this. Yes, we can make out both are equal. The parts shaded are equal. So these two are equivalent fractions. So, but this is 1/3. It is already given. This is what? There are 9 parts. Out of it, how many are shaded? That will be the answer. So 3 are shaded. So 1/3 is equal to 3/9. These two are equivalent fractions. Now let's see the next question. Again, it has given the equivalent sign. Equal sign here. So these two fractions are equal. What's the question? 3/- is equals to 1/4. So let's check out. 3 parts are shaded, already given. The number of parts we need to know. So let's count it. What is the number of parts here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So the missing number will be 12. So 3/12 is equal to 1/4. These two fractions are equivalent fractions, right, my children? Now again, let's see what's the question over here. The numerator is missing, the denominator is already given. So, and here this is 1/2, we already know this 1/2, and this will be the 5 parts. So missing number will be 5. This is quite easy, no? Peanuts, we can just do it very easily. So 5/10 is equal to 1/2. These two are equivalent fractions. Now let's go for the next question. Color the following to show equivalent fractions. Now you can have fun with this activity. You have to just color and show the fraction is given under. Now 1/2 is equals to 2/4. You have to shade the half part of it here, 2/4 of it, and you have to show the equivalent fraction. This you can pause the video and draw these circles and then do it in your own notebook. Okay, now 6/9, that means here you have to shade the 6 parts out of this 9 parts, and from this 2/3, that means you have to shade the 2 parts of it, right, my children? So easy, isn't it? This one you do it by yourself. I have just given one example and the rest you do it yourself. Let's do few more questions of exercise 7B. Observe the grouping and fill in the blanks. Let's see this question. We have here some oranges. Now what's the question given? 6/8 equals to -4. So we can see the fraction 6/8 over here. 8 oranges are there, out of it 6 are shaded, so 6/8. So now there are 4 groups. Okay, the 4 total number of group is given at the bottom. So what will be the numerator now? So 1, 2, 3 groups are shaded. So I think the missing number is 3. Yes, correct. So let's see another example. Now we have here, what's the fraction given? 4/6 equals to 2-. The denominator is missing now. So here we can make out very clearly that 4 are shaded out of 6. So 4, 6 is this one. Now here, if this is in the group form. So in this 2 are shaded groups. So 2 is the numerator. What will be the denominator? How many groups are there? 1, 2, 3. So I think the missing number is 3 here also. Easy, my children? Dear children, do this homework. Exercise 7A and 7B to be done in the textbook. I hope you have understood the concepts which I have taught today. Thank you. That's all for today. Let's meet some other time and have fun with maths.